Good morning everyone. Last class we have discussed regarding the pratyahara. Pratyahara means the withdrawing the senses from outside to inside. Like our eyes goes outside, we need to bring it to inside the chitta. Like our senses goes out, we need to bring it to the chitta. That's called asamprayoga chitta sarpa anukara. The anukara should be there like a chitta. That's called the pratyahara. And we have seen the benefits also. Now today we'll be talking the next limb, which is called as dharana. What is dharana? Explain here. Listen please. Deshabandha chittasya dharana. I repeat. Deshabandha chittasya dharana. So the dharana definition is given here. Deshabandha chittasya. Deshabandha chittasya. Desha means the actual the place. Or the location. Okay. And the location may be inside or outside. If I take the location is antarang, inside, inner or outer. If I take the outer or inner, two locations will be there where we should do dharana. Like outer location you can take like the inner will be there, Navi Chakra, Hridaya, Hridaya Pundarika, then Murdha Jyotishi. Okay, Murdha Jyotishi we can do. We can go for the Nashika Gra. Okay, and here in case of this place, in case of this outer, we can go for different types of statue or Murti. So in these places, if we bring our concentration, that's called the dharana. What is telling here? Desha. This is called the plesha. Plesha may be inside your body or outside your body. Internal, it may be external dharana. Internal means it should be, the object must be inside your body. Or outer means the object must be outside your body. It may be statue, murti, any kind of gross structure, guru picture, photo, anything. Bandha means the holding. In Hatabandhi it tells Bandha means holding, like Jalandhara Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, Moola Bandha, all these things. Here Bandha means bringing your chitta, chittasya. See, you need to bring your chitta to here, to the this kind of places. It may be outer inner place or it may be outer place. So what is the concept we explain here? Chitta must be put into a particular point. You need to bring. Bandha means bandhanam. See, if I hold your hands, I can bandha. I can hold your hand, means I will do bandhanam. But you may go from away from me. So you will be trying to go away. Still, I will try to hold. So what is happening there? The chitta will be trying to hold the chitta in a particular place. It may be inside the body. It may be outside your body. Again, the concentration will be reduced. Again, you need to bring from there. So here the concentration is not very constant. Okay, here the not constant concentration. Okay, concentrations. It's a divided concentration. Divided concentration. Means sometimes you are focusing, sometimes you are getting distraction. Again, you are bringing that. Okay, so this is the meaning explained here in this sutra. So what is the meaning of this sutra is explained here. Deshabandha chittasya dharana. The dharana means the holding. Okay, dharana. It's the pre-stage of dhyana. We are talking regarding the antaranga yoga, remember. Antaranga yoga. Last class we stopped regarding, we'll discuss already regarding bahyanga. There are first five are there under ashtanga, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama and pratyahara. All those five are connected to the external practice and these three. Dharana, Dhyana and Samadhi will be talking. These three is called as the Antaranga practice or inner practice. Okay, and this inner practice are very helpful to reach the ultimate aim of yoga, which is Kaivalyam or Asamprajnata Dharmayoga Samadhi. So what is the meaning explained regarding this sutra is the Dharana. Dharana means you can take a word as concentration. Okay, the concentration must be done. Okay, concentration of whom? Concentration of चित्ता एंड चित्ता इज मेड ऑफ थ्री थिंग्स एम बी ए और अंतरंगा अंतकरण यू कैन टेक वन मोर वर्ड अंतकरण 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 ओके सो द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन शुड बी डन ऑफ चित्ता हाउ बाय द होल्डिंग बाय प्रेशरिंग बाय द बलपूर्वक Your chitta will go from here to there, here to here to there, but still you need to bring it back. Where the place is, it may be outside your body or maybe inside your body. So this is the pre-stage of dhyanam. Before going to dhyana, you should practice this. So this is a very much important sutra regarding the antaranga practice. You should know this. Hope you clear. So let's see the next one. Yes. The next part is called as dhyanam. If you got mastery over that, Which practice? Dharana. So that only. Dharana, there is no, again, you need no need to practice dhyana. No, we cannot practice dhyana. Dhyana is known as the meditations. Remember, dharana is called concentrations, as I already said, and dhyana is the meditations. What is meditation? Explain here. Tatra pratyektanata dhyanam. Tatra प्रत्यय एकतानता एकता आनता ध्यानम द ध्यान मेडिटेशन इज कॉल्ड तत्र मीन्स इट्स रिलेटेड टू प्रीवियस सूत्र इज कनेक्टेड टू धारणा सो इन द स्टेट ऑफ धारणा ओनली रिमेंबर वी कैन नॉट डू कॉन्सेंट्रेशन द वी कैन नॉट डू मेडिटेशन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विल बी देयर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन देन इज कॉल्ड मेडिटेशन ओके The meditation goes continuously. That is called the samadhi. We'll be talking in next sutra also. So the concentration we can do here. This is in our hand, dharana. Then we cannot do meditation. It is not in our hand. If we concentrate deeply here, it will get into meditation, dhyana. That one explain here. Tatra. Tatra means in the stage of dharana. Okay. धारणा प्रत्यय एकतानता प्रत्यय मीन्स द नॉलेज और ज्ञानम नॉलेज ज्ञानम एकतानता मीन्स मेकिंग वन पॉइंटेड सी इट्स कॉल्ड वन पॉइंटेड दैट इज नोन एज ध्यानम सो बिफोर इन केस ऑफ प्रीवियस सूत्र इन द धारणा लेवल व्हाट विल हैपन धारणा लेवल यू आर नॉट वन पॉइंटेड चित्त इज अनफोकस्ड Sometimes concentrate if you hold if you sit for a practice concentration maybe 10 minutes 2 minutes or hardly 3 minutes you can concentrate remaining 7 8 minutes chitta goes here and there again you are bringing that chitta that's called bandha in case of dharana but in case of this dhyana meditation what will happen in the state of dharana only when it's going on practicing the persons and you got the mastery over that so that state become the automatic dhyana that state only that's called tatra And what happened in the state? Instead of dhyana, pratya ekadana tada. Pratya, knowledge will be one-pointed dhyana. Like you know the story of Arjuna in Mahabharata. When all other Pandavas were asked, what can be seen? What is way visible? So everyone told, I can see this and this and this and this. Then Arjuna told, I can see the eye only, not even bird. So that kind of high level concentration, that's called as the dhyanam meditations. Okay, there are so many types of different types of meditation are there. But Patanjali did not mention any kind of meditations. If you go to Hatha Yogic text, they mention Stula, Sukshma, Jyoti in Grand Samhita. So those level concentrations are there. But here, this concentration also related to the Guna, Sattva Guna. So this also not good our aim. Our aim is to reach the Guna Atita state. So this is not the ultimate aim, Dhyana. Some person may be enjoying the Dhyana. They will be closing eyes and they will be enjoying something, thinking something. That is not the actual aim. Actual aim is to concentrate what he is performing, what he is thinking. Okay, for example, I am sitting for the Krishna Nam. For example, I am thinking about the Krishna Nam. But I am thinking in a chitta, I will sit for do Krishna Nam, but I am thinking Rama Nam. No, it don't happen. Even though everyone is same, Rama Krishna same, but why can't you do for the Krishna Japa? Okay. So this how explained there. So dhyana must be done for a long time when the dharana itself transfer into the dhyana that is called as the dhyanam okay There are, if you go to Sankhya Sutra, they explain one nine is Dhyanam Nirvishyam Manaha. Nirvishyam Manaha. Dhyana level, what happened? The Vishya. Vishya will not be there. Deeply concentration means what you are concentrating, you will become one with that things. So that level concentration known as the Dhyana or meditations. So which is very important limbs under Ashtanga Yoga. So this is the seventh limb we already discussed today. Sixth and seventh limb. Dharana and Dhyana. And next we will be talking regarding the last limbs, which is called as the Samadhi. Remember here, this Samadhi is related to Sampragyata, not Asampragyata. Okay, it means it's related to the Sattuguna. Okay, so this is how we need to understand this Sutra. Hope you understood. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Yes, thank you very much. Bye-bye.